If you're Beyonce, indeed, if you're any black woman and you release a song, just buckle up because you know the right wing is going to be coming for you. Take a look at what Fox and Friends had to say about Beyonce's recent work.
Ravi, do you know, like when you get a little bit older, sometimes you mellow? I mean, she's a parent. You know, you would think we haven't really seen her in a while, barely dressed, dancing around. And now she comes back more vile than ever, putting out X-rated lyrics. Plus, what about the dimpled ass community? What about them? Yeah. Are they insulted by being used in her songs? Have you thought about that?
Right. Or those with stretch mark breasts, apparently. I won't recreate the words she uses in her delightful lyric, written by Drake. Incidentally, he wrote those lovely lyrics, but why you would sing them as a renowned woman who young people look to, I don't quite get that.
Right, and they were wonderfully put together. They have great poetry there. I think it'll go down in history.
I think it'll go down in history. She will. She's already gone down in history. She is fabulously famous and has an absolutely massive fan base that has been well earned by literally decades of hard work. You may not like the songs. You may not choose to listen to it. That's your right. But mocking it as irrelevant because of the X-rated lyrics, who even says that anymore? What? Are you a child? Are you a thousand? I don't know which it is that is causing you to be unable to accept the fact that there is art out there that isn't tailor-made for your awful juvenile tastes. She has a song and she says some words. And there might even be good arguments to not use some of them. We'll get to that. But the fact that she mentioned a dimpled ass or stretch marks, and you try to imply jokingly, I guess if it could be called to be a joke, that they would be offended to be mentioned. No, she is in fact providing representation by talking about it in that way. I mean, so much of this is going over their head. The specific references, as well as the overall concept of art and what the point of it is, it's all lost in them. One thing isn't though, that she is famous and they want to talk about her. They all do. We're going to get to Ben Shapiro in a sec, but they all so badly want to be a part of the conversation about Beyonce, even though they purport to not be interested in her work.
What they're trying to figure out is how this woman, who's now a parent, she needs to calm down with these lyrics. You know, she's a parent and maybe her kids would be disgusted by her lyrics, because you know, these libs don't know how to raise good children with their filthy lyrics. Ted Nugent is 73 damn years old. Ted Nugent writes songs with lyrics like this. Well, I don't care if you're just 13. You look too good to be true. I just know that you're probably clean. There's one little thing I gotta do to you. Ted Nugent is 73 damn years old. Ted Nugent has kids named Sasha, Rocco, Theodore, Tobias Nugent, Star Nugent, Chantal Nugent. It's almost like none of their arguments make any sense. Mm-hmm. 73, how old do conservative supporting artists have to be before they can stop writing and performing filthy lyrics, you know, about children? Because they have children. I don't remember Beyonce having any lyrics about sleeping with people that are the age of her children. I'm not sure how old his children are. Probably 50 years old.
They're probably about 50. Yeah, so her showing a bit of her ass or something, obviously worse for the modern day 2022 right wing than wanting to groom a 13-year-old. That's an interesting turn for them, considering what they've been talking about politically recently. Anyway, as I alluded to, there are, I think, more fair requests for a change in lyrics than whatever those two old losers were talking about. So people were asking for the word spaz to be removed from her song. You can see headlines discussing this. It is viewed as an ableist term for those with cerebral palsy. So that seems perfectly legitimate. I mean, I'm sure a lot of people have used the term not knowing that that is how it can be used or interpreted. But it looks like she is listening to those concerns and she is changing it. That isn't even good enough for those people. They go on in the clip. We're not gonna play more for you, but they complained about her changing those lyrics. They are busy asking her to change lyrics, but they're bothered by the fact that she changed lyrics. And then you get to Ben Shapiro and he doesn't understand why you would use such filthy, foul language, but you'd take out this. Well, one is interpreted as attacking a specific group. The other is just acknowledging that sex is a thing. Do you not get the difference between those two things? Why do you think that the acknowledgement of sex is so much worse than what could at least be interpreted as a targeted attack against a group? And yet he does have more to say. So really fast, we have to go to these. He says, he references WAP saying, having full scale songs for children about the moisture state of your vagina, that is Shakespearean wonder. It is. That's just the stuff you should play for your kids. It's very empowering stuff. Ben, why are you so terrified of sex? Honestly, like you're ostensibly a dad. There has to have been some encounters in the past, but you're horrified at the fact that anyone would acknowledge it. It's the sexual elephant in the room. Maybe you can do it behind closed doors in the dark and then feel really shamed about it for the rest of your life. But nobody should ever acknowledge it. Nobody should ever make art about it. This like core foundational part of our life and our emotional development and our relationships. No one should ever acknowledge that at all. To do so would be inconvenient.
I'm not sure how they convince enough people that music somehow just got filthy. It was filthy in the 50s. It was filthy way back when. People always talked about things like this in their lyrics and their songs. That's why every time there's new music, even in that era, they're like, did you guys hear that new music? It's so filthy. Because everyone of the previous generation of music thinks that the next one is either mumbling, doesn't have the right kind of lyrics, it's too filthy, doesn't play the right kind of music, isn't really musically inclined. All these things get criticism for the next level of music until that becomes the norm. Then the next thing is outrageous to folks again. Ben Shapiro's playing that same role. He's like, I guess I'll represent the old folks who are mad about music that have no idea what's being played. Because guess what? These folks who don't want to hear about the moisture levels of your vagina, they never heard of the song until you brought it up.
Exactly. You're supposedly not even listening to it. What do you care? I honestly, like, I don't know what most conservative musicians talk about, and I don't criticize it because I don't know, because I don't care. You say you don't care, but you really do seem to. Why do you care so much? Anyway, I would like to apologize. In the past, I have implied, if not stated, that Ben Shapiro serves roughly one purpose in our society, which is to co-opt young potential conservatives into being so obsessed with culture war stuff that they accept the economic dominance of those in the status quo. He has a second one. I do think that if you need to prolong sex before reaching some sort of conclusion, you can just remember him citing the moisture state of your vagina. And I think that that's gonna put a damper on things for a little bit. It might end the whole encounter, actually. It might be too strong, but my God, the moisture state of your vagina.
Damper. On it, John. Come on, bro.
100%.
By the way, writing lyrics.
If I ever do go to bar trivia again, my team is definitely going to be called the moisture state of your vagina. is a Shakespearean wonder.